Welcome to the Voice of the Lord. Our verse for today is in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 32. Remember those early days after you had received the light, when you stood your ground in a great contest in the face of suffering. This should be an encouragement to those that are suffering today. Yes, there are times when we are tempted to believe that once you become a believer, friends, life will be good. It will be problem-free. No suffering at all. But not so. You know why? It is because you are now in Christ. You are following Christ. You have turned away from the devil, friends. You used to walk with him. Now you are walking with the Lord. And therefore he is furious. He wants to take you back. And he will come to oppress you, to entice you, to tempt you, that you may fall in your walk, that again you will go back to him. That is the work of the devil. He comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But friends, stand your ground. Don't let the devil prevail. In fact, even the Apostle Paul had to remind Timothy that if anyone wants to live holy and blameless life, they will go through persecution. So friends, persecution is part of our Christian walk. Why? Again, we are just being tested in our faith. Will we pass the test? So we are now being reminded, friends, that remember those former days when you stood your ground. Yes, you passed the test in the past because you were so in love with the Lord. See, you had just received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and you were tested. And we are told that in those days, you stood your ground in the midst of suffering. See, it was a contest, friends, at the time. We were competing with the devil, and we persevered, and we stood our ground, and we won. And so we are now being reminded, friends, that this time around, if you are now to go through this kind of suffering, or any kind of suffering, continue to stand your ground. Continue to have faith in the Lord. Amen. Don't yield. Don't give in. Don't turn back. Remember that the Lord will sustain you, and he will keep you. He will make you strong, friends, even in the midst of persecution. You have tasted it in the past. He allowed you to go through it in the past, and you have seen the grace of God. You have seen the power of God displayed powerfully, friends, in the past. And we are taught that today, when you stand your ground, friends, you will see the same deliverance that God had done in the past. Amen. And so, friends, if you are in a situation that you are tempted to give up in your faith today, well, remember what Jesus had done in the past. Remember that it's through his death on the cross that he delivered you. And therefore, friends, the power of the blood of Jesus will continue to be manifested in your life. You will overcome because you are standing firm on your faith in him. Amen. So don't give up, friends. Attend Bible studies, attend worship services, read the Bible every day, friends. This is one way, friends, of keeping you strong in the faith, that you may stand your ground. Amen. Continue to feed yourself with the Word of God, because this will sustain you. This will nourish you, friends. This will be your vitamins that keep you strong and spiritually healthy. Remember that the Word of God is very powerful, sharper than any double-edged sword. And you can get it, friends, when you read the Bible. And also, remember that you got to increase in faith. Now we are told that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the inner voice of the Lord. Amen. And so, friends, be blessed today. Be encouraged. Stand your ground. Don't give in. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you, and lift up his countenance on you and give you his Shalom. God bless. See you next time. Bye.